Okay, so what we're doing is this is for Kellogg Community College. This is for the prep test that I created for the chapter or the Unit 2 test, which went over a little bit of Chapters 2 and 3. And these questions here are focused more on Section 3.1, and they all deal with a simple formula: distance equals rate times time. It means if you're going to go somewhere, you got to travel at a certain speed for a certain length of time. And that distance equals rate times time is going to kind of give you what you need to solve these two problems. Now it says Lori hiked from her campsite to Green Lake. She hiked at a rate of 3 miles per hour going to the lake and 4 miles per hour coming back. Now each of these problems have to deal with two separate things, and they were identified in the problem. You're going to the lake and you're also coming back from the lake. So the to and from become the parts of the table that we're going to make with the headings of distance equals rate times time. Okay, and let's go see what we can kind of, you know, get from this here. Okay, so we've got a column for D, R, and T. She hiked at a rate of 3 miles an hour going to the lake. Now that's a rate right there. So going to the lake is going to be 3 miles an hour. And 4 miles per hour coming back. So 4 miles an hour there. The trip to the lake took 3 hours longer than the trip back. So the trip to the lake took a certain amount of time plus three. And coming back from the lake, it took just that certain amount of time. I'll say that again and kind of show it to you here. The trip to the lake took 3 hours longer than the trip back. So the trip there was x, or the trip back was x, and the trip there was x plus 3. How long did it take for her to hike to the lake, and what was the distance? Now, here's the thing. The distance to and from the lake is exactly the same. The distance hasn't changed between the time that she walked there and back, so that's just d. Now, to set this equation up, you'll notice that the d is equal to this equation, the r times t, and the distance is also 4 times x. Now, if this is equal to this and this is equal to this because of the transitive property, we can say that the distance to the lake, 3 times x plus 3, is the same as the distance from the lake, which is 4 times x. And this just becomes a problem that we can solve now. And let me get that a little bit on the camera. So we're going to distribute the 3 to the x plus 3, which is 3x plus 9. And then 4 times x is 4x. We're going to solve for x by subtracting the 3x from both sides. And since I'm using a pretty thick marker here, I'm kind of running out of room. So I'm going to transfer this to the right-hand side here. The 3x's simplify, the 9 carries on, and the 4x minus the 3x is just 1x, or x itself. So here we now know that x is equal to 9. Now, from the table, x is the time it takes to get from the lake. So it must have taken her to get to the lake 9 plus 3. So to answer the first question, how long does it take her to get to the lake? That answer right there is 9 hours. Or 9 plus 3 hours, sorry, excuse me, which is 12. 12 hours to get to the lake and 3 hours to get from the lake. Let's see. And let's go to the next question. What is the distance from her? What is the distance from her to the campsite right there? Well, that's easy. You could just take your 4 and the 9, and so your distance is 36 miles. So I know it's getting a little cramped here, but we'll just make a little arrow right there, and that answer is going to be 4 times 9, which is 36. Okay, let's move on to the next problem. Pretty much, the DRT problems continue just in this mode, D equals R times T. If it takes Ellen 8 hours, there we go. If it takes Ellen 8 hours to drive to a friend's cabin, and Hazel only takes 7 hours to drive to the cabin by driving 10 miles faster an hour than Helen. Well, we're gonna set up our D equals R times T. And can you figure out the two things we're talking about now? We're not talking about to and from the lake anymore, are we? We're talking about two different drivers. The first driver is going to be Ellen, And it says Ellen, it takes Ellen 8 hours to drive to a friend's cabin. So the rate is going to be unknown, but we do know her time is 8. And Hazel, who's going to be my second person here, Hazel only takes 7 hours, so she takes, but she does it by going 10 miles per hour faster than Ellen. So Ellen's going X and Hazel's going X plus 10. Well, your distance going to where they're going is not going to change. They both went the same way, just one went faster than the other. So we set, since Ellen is this and Hazel is this, due to the transitive property, we can say that the X is equal to the 7 times the X plus 10. And I use the commutative property to switch the 8 and the x around, and the commutative property to move the 7 and the x plus 10 around. So I got 8x is equal to 7x plus 70. Move the 7x over here. You'll see this is nice because the 8x and the 7x make 1x or just x. X is equal to 70 miles an hour. So Ellen was going 70 miles an hour, and Hazel was going 80 miles an hour. So the answer is, what is Hazel's average speed? Hazel's average speed was 70 plus 10, which is 80. Sorry, again, it's getting a little cramped there, but I am using a thick pen. And how far did they have to drive to get to the cabin? Well, Ellen went 70 times 8, and Hazel went 80 times 7. So you can do any of those. 70 times 8 or 80 times 7 is 540 miles to get to the cabin. There you go. There is two of the sample problems. Pretty much the other problems on the practice test kind of are all, they all deviate from these just very slightly. Sometimes we know the rates and not the times, and sometimes we know the times and not the rates. But every problem can be set up in the same way, where you set the d's equal to each other or the two equations equal to each other, solve for x, and then do the problems. Problems 43 and 44 are pretty much the same things. I'll let you practice these with the worksheets that you have, and you can email me for more questions on that. Thank you.